this Sabbath seems to be a Sabbath of new events right now. So we're going to have our children's story. So as the children prepare, would you please go to the back and get the baskets? And then we will put our offerings for the children in the baskets. And Carolyn is going to give you our...
Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, boys and girls.
How many of you have ever been to the doctor's office? No. What were you there for? Well, we usually go to the doctor because we're either sick, or sometimes we go because we're going to have an exam before we start school. And you remember when you went to the doctor's office? The waiting room, you wait, and then the nurse will come and get you and take you down the hall to the waiting, to the exam room, and then she'll have you sit up on the examination table. She'll ask questions to the person that brought you to the doctor's office, and then you wait a little longer, and then the doctor comes in. And one of the first things the doctor does when he comes to examine you, checks your heart first is because if your heart isn't right, it's going to affect everything else. So sometimes another way to check your heartbeats is with your pulse. Put your fingers here because your heartbeats cause this pulse here at your wrist. Now I'm going to ask you to stand up, just the kids, and turn around and look at the adults because I'm going to ask them a question and I want you to count how many people raise their hands. So stand up and turn around. And now adults, are you ready? Here's the question. How many of you, when you got up this morning, checked your pulse to make sure your heart was still beating? Nobody. Okay, you can sit back down. Thank you. Nobody checks their pulse to make sure their heart is still beating. Because God put within us a system called the autonomic nervous system. And that automatically makes your heart beat. And if we don't think about it, it's just an automatic thing. And so, God put this system within us, and because we don't think about it, there's a reason in the scriptures why we don't. Do you know why we don't think about it? Okay, in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, it says, "Then the Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and he became a human being." Now, when God created Eve, he put Adam to sleep, and he opened up his side, and he pulled out a rib, and he created Eve from that rib. Now, does your Bible say that when God created Eve, he breathed into her the breath of life? No. Why? Because the rib already had life in it.
That's why the wife sign.
What's that?
The wife.
Oh, life? Oh, okay. So God didn't need to breathe into Eve the breath of life because there was already life there. The autonomic nervous system was already in place, and it has been with everybody that's been born since then. Now, I've been talking about our physical health, but our message today is going to be focused on our spiritual health. And the speaker is going to use a certain word many times. And it's just a short word. It's four letters long. And I want you to listen for that word. And after the service, if you think you know what that word is, you come to me because I have something for you. Okay? See, God cares so much about our physical health and our spiritual health. Our spiritual health is our relationship with God. So, our closing scripture is found in 3 John, verse 2, and it says, "Beloved, I pray in all respects that you may prosper and be in good health," that's our physical health, "just as your soul prospers." That's our spiritual. Loving Father, we are fearfully and wonderfully made. We thank you so much for anticipating all of our needs. And now we humbly ask that we would surrender our entire life to you this day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.